Okay, so you ready? So ladies and gentlemen, can you all please stand for the entrance of the bridal party? Ceremony. I just need to ask each of you in turn to confirm your full names. By tradition, John, we're going first all the way through. Is your full name John Peter Riley? Is your full name Sally Ann Jackson? Now this place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. We are all here today to witness the joining together in matrimony of John Peter Riley and Sally Ann Jackson. If any person present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, they must declare it now. For John and Sally, today's ceremony is a public declaration of their intention to make a lifelong commitment to each other. They have found love and friendship, happiness and fulfilment in their relationship, and now they have chosen to offer each other the strength and security that comes with marriage. May their commitment be deepened and enriched by marriage vows to be made sincerely and kept faithfully. I'm sure all of you present will celebrate with them and share in their happiness as they publicly mark this new phase in their relationship. Now, John and Sally, before you are joined together in matrimony, it is my duty to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows that you're about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life and to the exclusion of all others. Do you both understand the nature of the commitment you are about to make to each other today? Please reply, I do. So you can now look like to turn to face each other. Turn to face each other and hold hands across. I'm now going to ask each of you in turn to make a public declaration to state that you are lawfully free to marry. So John, if you could repeat after me. I declare that I know.
I declare that I know.
Of no legal reason.
No legal reason.
Why I, John Peter Riley.
I, John Peter Riley.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In marriage.
In marriage.
To Sally Ann Jackson.
To Sally Ann Jackson.
I declare that I know.
I declare that I know.
Of no legal reason.
Of no legal reason.
Why I, Sally Ann Jackson.
Why I, Sally Ann Jackson.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In marriage.
In marriage.
To John Peter Riley.
To John Peter Riley.
So we have now come to the solemn part of the ceremony, where John and Sally are to form their contracted marriage and then say their personal marriage promises. And this will be followed with an exchange of rings, which in the past has always been seen as a traditional way of sealing the marriage contract. But here today is also the outward sign of the lifelong commitment that they're about to make to each other. And as this is the reason that you're here today, I invite you all to please stand once more to witness this moment. So these are the words that will form your contracted marriage to John Peter and Sally. I call upon these persons here present.
These persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
John Peter Riley.
John Peter Riley.
Do take thee.
Do take me.
Sally Ann Jackson.
Sally Ann Jackson.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I call upon these persons here present.
These persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Sally Ann Jackson.
Sally Ann Jackson.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
John Peter Riley.
John Peter Riley.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Thank you very much.
So if you two would now like to go for seat.
If everyone would like to take their seats once more. And you've got a cheer at the perfect moment. So now for your personal marriage promises. So I will ask the promise and your response should be I do. So John, do you take Sally to be your wife and share your life with her?
I do.
Do you promise to love and respect Sally, comfort and care for her at all times?
I do.
And John, do you solemnly promise that you will always protect Sally with your utmost care, that you will respect and support her throughout your life together, and that in all things you will be to her a faithful and loving husband? Sally, do you take John to be your husband and share your life with him?
I do.
And do you promise to love and respect John, comfort and care for him at all times?
I do.
And Sally, do you solemnly promise that you will always protect John with your utmost care, that you will respect and support him throughout your life together, and that in all things you will be to him a faithful and loving wife?
I do.
So we will now conclude the ceremony with the exchange of rings. And apart from sealing the marriage contract, the unbroken circle of the wedding ring signifies the enduring nature of the vows and the promises that John and Sally have said to each other today. So John, if you like to take the ring for Sally and place it on the third finger of the left hand, holding it in place as she will wear it from today. Repeat after me, say to Sally. Sally, I give you this ring.
Sally, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a lasting reminder.
As a lasting reminder.
Of the promises.
Of the promises.
We have made today.
We have made
today. Okay. Sally, would you like to take the ring for John? bracelet on the third finger of his left hand, holding it in place as he will wear it from today. Repeat after me, but say to John. John, I give you this ring.
John, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a lasting reminder.
And as a lasting reminder.
Of the promises.
Of the promises.
We have made today.
We have made today.
I'm holding hands up for hands now. So to help to bring their ceremony to a lovely conclusion, John and Sally have chosen a reading. This is going to be presented by Tom. So Tom, if you'd like to come forward.
First and foremost, I'd like to thank Sally and John for the humble and privileged to be part of today. Thank you. All you need is love. All you need is love. A song written by two men from Liverpool in 1967, which poses the question, what is love? I was once asked this question, and this was my answer. I believe love is the perfume of the wondrous flower, the heart, and heaven is here on earth, and we are all God's. For me, love never dies, but needs watering every day. Love is the foundation of our lives. It transcends all other emotions. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not self-seeking, but rejoices in truth. We are here today to celebrate the special love between two very special people, Sally and John. When we are together, just look at their eyes. This is love. A love that has found a resting place in their hearts. A love that is enduring, beguiling, and real. It's there for all to see. They bring joy to each other, all they need. Sally and John, may all your tomorrows have memories, and may all your memories have love.
Thank you very much. That's lovely. So John and Sally, you have declared your commitment to each other in the presence of your family and friends, and you have made solemn and binding promises to each other and have symbolised your marriage with the exchange of rings. So it now gives me very great pleasure to declare that you are husband and wife. Do you want to kiss your beautiful bride? At this point, and there should be some music playing, so if you just want to chat or complete the legalities, thank you.
Congratulations. Don't take photos. Yeah, we don't. Yeah. How's it going so far?
Great. Oh, 5 minutes of it. Just behind you, if you need me. So, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes mine and Talitha's part of today's celebration. So, we hope you all have a lovely rest of the day. And if I can just ask you to stand one last time. Join me in a round of applause for the new Mr. and Mrs. Riley!